You know I love skincare. I really do. But even the things we love the most do sometimes have limitation, and it's really important to know and accept them in order to avoid a disappointment and frustration. And yes, I'm really talking about skincare here. This is not disguised marriage counseling, even though you could probably apply this statement to both. Many people approach me after my reviews with the question, will insert random product cure my acne, erase my wrinkles, heal my eczema? And in the majority of cases, the answer is no. It has to be. Why? That's what we're going to talk about today. Hi, I'm Dr. Anne. I'm a medical doctor with a passion for skincare that works. On this channel, we explore the science behind skin and do quick reviews so you learn to pick exactly those products that work for your individual skin concern. So if this is something you're interested in, please consider subscribing and ring the notification bell. To understand why the answer is no in 99% of the products I review, we need to talk about what is the difference between cosmetics, over-the-counter drugs, and drugs. Well, cosmetics are products designed to be applied to the skin in order to cleanse, beautify, or alter the appearance, while drugs are intended for use in the diagnosis, cure, mitigation, treatment, or prevention of disease, or intended to affect the structure or any function of the body. And as acne and eczema are diseases, and because I do not review drugs here, as they are usually prescription, and I want you to talk to your doctor too if you have questions about the prescription rather than turn to YouTube, the individual products I talk about are not able to cure acne or eczema or psoriasis or skin cancer. The small exception are what is referred to as over-the-counter drugs in the US, something we do not have in Germany. I mean, we do have the products, we just don't make the distinction between cosmetics and over-the-counter drugs. Over-the-counter drugs are products that contain an ingredient with known therapeutic benefits that is considered safe to be sold without a prescription. They are regulated in terms of what they claim and at what percentages the therapeutic ingredient can or needs to be used in order to make that claim. Common examples are salicylic acid products, sunscreens, or fluoride toothpaste. In some countries, not in the European Union, the exact listing of active ingredients and their percentage is required. So, over-the-counter drugs could treat and possibly cure diseases, which makes them different from your usual cosmetic product. What a product is, it's not only determined by the ingredients, but also by the claims. If a product claims to alter your body in any shape or form, like increase collagen production, for example, it is a drug because it claims to alter your body. If, on the other hand, it claims to help increase collagen production, it still is a cosmetic because help is not the drug claim. And just as a reminder, acne, psoriasis, and eczema are skin diseases. Wrinkles, dullness, and dehydration are not. Generally speaking, they're just cosmetic concerns. Why is it unlikely that cosmetics will alter your body and heal diseases? Other than the ingredients used, it's the area they are working at. Skincare products usually are not designed to penetrate deep into the body. A typical ingredient in an effective skincare product can break up the dead stratum corneum cells and can cause a reactive proliferation of the basal keratinocytes, but most creams do not penetrate through the epidermis. Put simple, they affect the outer layer of the skin, where they can have a tremendous effect in terms of hydration and beautifying, but they will not reach areas of the body where they initiate structural changes. Does that mean that skincare is pointless? Absolutely not. Well-formulated skincare products go exactly where they need to go to deliver the results they are designed for. A chemical exfoliant, for example, makes a huge difference in texture-ridden skin, and for that effect, it doesn't need to go any deeper than the upper layers. Same is true for hydration, for smoothing, for reduction of transepidermal water loss, all of which have more than a temporary effect on your skin's appearance and, in the long term, health. Another aspect is how skincare makes you feel. Not how it makes your skin feel, how it makes you as a person feel. Relaxed, happy, appreciated. Skincare is self-care, and skincare should be a pleasant experience. If I were to focus on results exclusively, I would stick to a basic cleanser, my tretinoin, and sunscreen, and would probably get at least 90% of the results I achieve now with much less time and money invested. No more dabbling with various potions and lotions, no more face masks and treatment nights. But where's the fun in that? And who can say that the fact that I am taking time to look after myself isn't beneficial for me in the long run? All I am saying is that to treat skin diseases, you should rely on drugs rather than cosmetics. But if you either don't have any skin diseases or they are taken care of by a professional with prescription products, cosmetics is what you should turn to support the results these drugs give you and even help counteract the side effects of your treatment, like dry and flaky skin during retinization, or simply to make your skin look even better. What would you be able to notice anyway? We often hear claims like 5% reduction in wrinkle death, 7% reduction in redness. All that sounds pretty impressive. But the question is, how big of a difference would you actually be able to notice in your daily life? If you don't have the habit of staring at your wrinkles with a magnifying glass all day, and if you have, you should seriously consider getting help, 5% will go completely unnoticed. You will not see these changes when you look in the mirror, at least not as much as you will see the results of a night with uninterrupted as opposed to a night with broken sleep. Don't believe me? Reduce the redness intensity of a square by 7% on your favorite picture alteration tool. Would you see a difference if you didn't know and didn't have the side-by-side comparison? I don't think you would, and that's a space much larger than the areas of redness on your face. Taking into account now that the changes in skin happen gradually over several weeks, how would you be able to spot the difference other than a, I like what I see when you look in the mirror? Where does retinol fit in here? I mentioned that tretinoin, aka retinoic acid, is a drug and can increase collagen production. At the same time, retinol creams usually are considered cosmetics, not drugs, even though retinol will, after two conversion steps, convert into retinoic acid. How's that possible? Well, technically, retinol creams do not contain an ingredient with known therapeutic effect. That would be retinoic acid, so they are not drugs. And second, the claims are usually something along the lines of help increase collagen production, which is, as we learned before, not a drug claim. They are cosmetics by definition, even though they may have a significantly weaker, similar effect as a drug would have. Or translated to consumers' needs, they may help prevent premature aging in a weaker, but at the same time much better tolerated way, but they will not be enough to treat severe acne. You need a drug and a doctor for that. Bottom line. All the things you can do to your skin are minor compared to sun protection. And that doesn't only mean sunscreen, it means being sun smart with protective clothing, hats, and avoiding the midday sun. The next step would be to decide if you have a severe skin condition or a skin disease, or if you simply want to improve the appearance of your skin, both in the short and in the long term. For the first, go see a doctor and rely on their advice and prescriptions. For the second, knock yourself out with whatever brings you joy and makes your skin look and feel better. Just don't feel the need to go in depth to buy skincare products you can't otherwise afford. Please let me know where you stand in terms of, are skincare products effective? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. I'm going to link to more videos on the screen that I think you might enjoy, and I'm going to see you all very soon with another one. Bye!